Hello and welcome to Entrepreneur Series with Elizabeth Itau. If you're new to this channel, please go ahead and hit the subscription button. If you have come back, karibu sana, and thank you so much for your continued support. So guys, today we continue with our story. I know you have been waiting for episode 8. Here it is. Remember I told you that Gureti mentioned that I should hire someone in the business. What I didn't tell you is the reason as to why Gureti mentioned that I should hire someone is because she would pass by the office and she would find it closed. And so I think she was wondering, why is this woman always closing her business? Why doesn't she hire someone? So you may be wondering, why was I closing my business? I was closing my business because I was having a challenge managing between working in my business and working on my business. And that is a very huge thing that when you're getting into entrepreneurship, you really have to learn how to work in your business and work on your business. So what do we mean by working in our business? Working in our businesses means that we are involved in the day-to-day running of the business, that we know what goes on in our business. Every single transaction, process, procedures, we are conversant with them. And as new entrepreneurs, we think that, I have left employment to become my own boss. So we get excited by the CEO title. But what we forget is when everyone else is talking of chief executive officer, we need to know that it means chief everything officer, that you are in charge of everything. So one mistake that we make as entrepreneurs when we start is we think that we are the chief executive officer and we forget to work on everything. Probably sometimes we find ourselves delegating, like I will tell you what I did, the mistake I did in this episode, and we think of ourselves as the boss and not as an employee. I remember when I applied for my NHIF form and I asked them, now do I start paying and I have not started hiring everyone? And they're like, no, you are the first employee of your business. So you start filing for you. So you are an employee. In as much as everyone thinks that you're the boss and you need to know that you're the first employee of your business. And the way you would work for a boss, remember to work the same way for you. And it can be very hard to maintain that balance because probably where you are reporting to someone and that is what made you so angry that you left employment to become now your own boss. This time around, you don't have someone who is accountable, whom you're accountable to, who you're reporting to, probably someone who can call you to the office and give you, you know, a lecture on why you came late, on why you didn't meet your target. You are that person. So you are the chief everything officer. So don't get carried away. Don't get excited about this being boss thing. Remember now, you are the boss. You are the employee. You are in charge of everything. So you have to really know how to manage that balance. Number two, now we talk about working on your business. Working on your business means that you are in charge of the planning, putting down a strategic plan, mapping out your clients, coming up with a sales plan, coming up with how the values for your business, the mission, the vision. You are now working on your business. So most of us get carried away on the managing the balance between working in our business and working on our business. So during the day, you may find yourself now you're working in your business, you're getting to know whether your plans are working. Then in the evening, you find yourself busy working on your business, putting down the strategies, doing an analysis, whether you hit your target, where you didn't hit your target, what are clients saying, what is it that you can put in place to make sure that you respond to the client. So you have to really learn on how to balance these two, because if you are inclined on one so much, the other side will fall. So the other mistake that I made is I networked way too early. As a new entrepreneur, it's good to network. Networking, I say, is an investment in time, energy, and resources. And for me, I networked so early where I invested money, time and effort that I was closing my business to go out. And the biggest challenge was I am out there looking for more business, but my business does not have the capacity to serve a larger audience. So guys, before you network, ensure that your business has the capacity to handle more business. And I would recommend networking to any entrepreneur at that point when you're scaling your business. When you have already laid the foundation, you're already growing, and now you want more customers, your business has the capacity to serve an extra clientele. So guys, before you go out networking intensively, like I did, ensure that your business is in order. Networking is very good, but you have to determine at what level of networking do I do. Like, for example, if your business is new, the networking you can do is online networking, where you set some time during the day, where you log into Facebook, to IG, to LinkedIn, and write an article. It is not very intensive. And maybe when you grow kidogo, you can go to this speed networking event, an afternoon event, you know, once in a week, or evening after you have done your work, you can go out and network. But the time that you get to the networking that I did, where you pay a club for a whole year subscription that requires you to go for meetings every week, that requires you to meet with the other partners on a weekly basis, that is intensive networking. That one, you leave it to when you have already delegated or you have employees, that even as you're looking for business, your business is going on and the clientele can be served. So guys, when you start your business, learn to manage a balance between working in your business and working on your business, and know when is the right time to network intensively or to just set a few hours to just network. So those are the mistakes that I made, and I believe that if I did what I did in a better way, my business would have thrived faster. So back to our story. I have hired someone whom I had taken from another agency. So she comes with the way they used to do business and another mindset that I did not even plan on hiring this employee to know what exactly am I looking for and how is it that you're going to work. So when she came the first month was very busy, because I recruited her in December, so she started working January. In our industry, it's the reaping year, the reaping month, like, you know, domestic workers leave work December, they don't report in January, so January is usually peak for us. So we were doing business and good business, and there was a pool of domestic workers. This lady, I was very connected, I was networking, I was bringing clients. But before long, I started receiving calls. Like in the second month now, the people we served in January, they were calling me, and they would call and with complaints. I got a lady from you, she's this and that. And so this is the time now I would go back to the office and I would ask, did you serve this client? How was it? And there is this complaint. And she would say, Apana, that one, she really insisted on getting this detail. So I talked to Fulani. Whoa, I realized that now she was fabricating information. Like for that client, she said that she wrote the next of kin or the reference contact as another lady who was also a domestic worker. I was furious, like, why would you lie on that form? And she was like, that is what we used to do. How are we going to get customers if we don't do this? I'm like, no, we know we're going to work on this honesty. Now that this was now the, you know, like where we started having conflicts, and I would come and ask for the I had put down the reference forms, the registration forms, the contract receipts, everything was written down. But now the mistake that I made is I got too excited with being the CEO and delegating, that I only would go back to the office probably to check the receipts, whether money has gotten into the bank. But I never got to ask, what did client A say? What did client B say? Whom did you serve with client X? And you served them with this candidate. I would go then go back and check whether all the processes were undertaken. So we may get too excited because you're the boss and forget that you need to work in your business. In as much as you're delegating, you need to create time to go back and see are the processes and procedures followed as the way I had put them. So we started now having these few conflicts. Then they became intense when I would now get more involved and I would reject some candidates. And she was like, if you keep rejecting these people, how are we going to do business? I'm like, if they can't convince me why I need to give them a job, then I won't work with them. She was infuriated. So the sales in January were high. In February now, when I started getting the conflicts, I got into the business and they started going down. They would go down because now people have already hired in January, but now they were going down because on top of me getting so many requests, I was declining so many candidates that we were to place. And the lady got furious and she was like, this is not how you run business. If you're going to do this, then you're not going to make money. Even where we were, we would do this. I'm like, no, leave the mindset of where you are. You're not working with me. You have to work with my rules, my terms and conditions. She couldn't have any of it. Now she started now looking for other things to do. So as I went out to network and look for more clients, I would tell her, make sure we have a pool of candidates that we can choose from. And even if a client needs a replacement, we have someone to replace them with. She got busy now doing her other things. She was selling bags. She was selling in my shop. So now I am sending clients to the office. No candidate to be placed. I go back to, and ask what is happening. She would tell me, point blank, you are rejecting my candidate. So there's not much that I can do. I'm like, wow, that's interesting. So at this point now, I was like, hey, this one is not really working. And at the end of the month, she would expect me to pay her salary. So we got to an agreement. I told her, now I'm going to give you notice. You're going to work in the month of March, and then you're going to end this contract because it's not one. And she was like, yeah, I was actually wondering when you're going to. Yanni, there was even disrespect. Actually, she worked like for only 2 weeks in the month of March, and I couldn't have any more of it because now the conflicts were so many. There was disrespect, a lot of familiarity. And she was in subordination. Like she didn't feel like I was the boss, because whatever she was bringing on the table, I was not taking it. So in the month of March, I had to release her. And now this was like the wake up call. Like, Elizabeth, you're networking too much. You're out and your business is falling. You need to figure out what is happening. Now the most interesting part is I got that wake up call and I decided now I'm going to do it for myself. Like, I'm going to be involved in the day-to-day operations of my business. And the most interesting part is when she left, she knew, like, I was getting so many clients and she thought that it's her. Because my efforts in meeting with clients, networking, were really paying off because I was getting so many clients. So she thought, because these ladies, like, would get so many requests in a day for a domestic worker. So she thought, here there is a lot of money. So what she did is she opened, like, we were in a block of offices or rooms. She took like the third from where I was and opened her own agency there. So now we became competitors in the same industry, and now I had to dip my both feet into the business and on the business. And let us meet next week as I tell you what happens after now I have a competitor and now I have to do the business myself. Thank you so much for watching, guys. This is Entrepreneur Series, where we dream it, believe it, work it, and enjoy it. Bye.